بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تمسك بسنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending the salutations upon the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, upon his family, upon his companions, and upon those who follow, upon his guidance into the establishment of the last day, into the establishment of the last day. To proceed, Ikhwan, فَسُبْحَانَكَ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِلَّا مَا عَلَّمْتَنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. Indeed, glory be to you, Ya Allah. We have no knowledge except that which you, Ya Allah, you have taught us. And indeed, you are Al-Alim, Al-Hakim. Al-Alim, Al-Hakim. The All-Knower and the All-Wise. The All-Knower and the All-Wise. فاللهم إنا نعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع ومن قلب لا يخشع ومن نفس لا تشبع ومن دعاء لا يسمع. And indeed, Ya Allah, we seek refuge with you from knowledge that has no benefit, from knowledge that has no benefit, and from a heart that has no fear, and from a heart that has no fear, and from a soul that has no satisfaction, no contentment, and from a dua that is unanswered, and from a dua that is unanswered. ثم أما بعد, to proceed further, يا إخوان, فنواصل معكم في هذه الليلة المباركة الكريمة عونا من الرحمن الرحيم عونا من الرحمن الرحيم. So we continue with our beloved brothers and our beloved mothers and our beloved daughters and our beloved sisters in Al-Islam in this blessed and noble night of ours, seeking the aid, seeking the aid, alaykum salam ya Shaykh, and the assistance of our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذَكِرَ النَّفْسِ وَإِيَّاكُمْ. Reminding ourselves firstly, and my brothers and my sisters secondly. كَمَا قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَى تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. الْآيَةُ سُورَةُ الذَّارِيَاتِ. الْآيَةُ سُورَةُ الذَّارِيَاتِ. As Allah Ta'ala, He mentions, and remind them, O Muhammad, for indeed the reminder benefits those who believe. Benefits those who believe. Surah Al-Dhariyat. Surah Al-Dhariyat. Qira'atan min kitabi.
What number is that?
Surah Al-Dhariyat 55, I believe. Surah Al-Dhariyat. Qira'atan min kitabi Shaykhina wa Imamina Al-Allama Al-Imam Al-Quh Al-Shaykh Salih Al-Fawzan. Al-Shaykh Salih Al-Fawzan, Hafidhahullahu Ta'ala, Hafidhahullahu Ta'ala. Reading from the book of the noble Imam, the noble Shaykh, Al-Imam Al-Quh, the pure and noble Imam, Al-Shaykh Salih Al-Fawzan, Hafidhahullahu Ta'ala, Hafidhahullahu Ta'ala. Min kitabihi Al-Mulakhas Al-Fiqhi. Reading from his book, The Summarized Fiqh, or fiqh summarized, or al-fiqh summarized. وَهَذَا الْكِتَابِ أَنَا أَنْصَحُ نَفْسِي وَإِيَّاكُمْ بِقِرَاءَتِهِ وَبِتَعْلِيمٍ مِّنْهُ وَبِحِفْظِهِ. أَنَا أَنْصَحُ نَفْسِي وَعَائِلَتِي وَإِخْوَتِي وَأَخَوَاتِي بِاشْتِرَاءِ هَذَا الْكِتَابِ بِشِرَاءِ هَذَا الْكِتَابِ وَبِقِرَاءَةٍ مِّنْ هَذَا الْكِتَابِ وَبِتَعْلِيمٍ مِّنْ هَذَا الْكِتَابِ وَبِالْبَحْثِ فِي هَذَا الْكِتَابِ فَهُوَ كِتَابٌ عَظِيمٌ عند الله سبحانه وتعالى سبحانه وتعالى. This book, يا إخوان, in the likes of this book, I advise myself firstly, and my brothers and my sisters secondly. I advise myself and my family and my brothers and my sisters with the purchasing of this book. With the purchasing of this book. No, I have this. Yeah, Ahmed.
No, thank you.
It's okay. With the purchasing of this book and the reading of this book, ماذا, and the studying and the learning from this book and the memorizing from this book or of this book, and with the research of or from this book. For indeed it's a tremendous book in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا نَزَالُ فِي بَابِ النِّكَاحِ. And we're still in the chapter of marriage. فعندما نقرأ عليكم يا إخوان من هذا الباب خاصة كأني أقرأ على نفسي. إلى نفسي. And we're reading from this chapter, Ikhwan, the chapter of marriage. It's as if I'm reciting or reading or teaching myself, especially in the chapter of marriage. فكم منا تزوجنا جهلا وكم منا يريد أن يتزوج ولكنه يجهل في مسائل النكاح وكم منا يريد الطلاق ولكنه يجهل في مسائل الطلاق إلى آخر هذه المسائل إلى آخر هذا أو هذه المسائل. How many from amongst us, يا إخوان, have married ignorantly? We have married ignorantly. And how many from amongst us intend to marry, but we do not know the issues or the affairs of marriage, the conditions of marriage, the obligations of marriage, the sunnah of marriage, the pillars of marriage? How many of us intend to divorce? And we don't know how to divorce. We don't know the affairs or the issues of divorce. الطلاق البدعي وطلاق السني. The divorce of innovation and the divorce of the sunnah. How many of us intend to have a sit down and we don't know the adab of having a sit down? طيب. تعلمنا من باب أحكام الخطبة. We have learned, والحمد لله, from the chapter of the legislation of becoming intended or proposing. The chapter of the legislation or the rulings of proposing to a young lady. وتعلمنا من باب عقد النكاح وأركانه وشروطه. We have already learned and discussed the chapter of the contract of marriage, its pillars, and likewise its conditions. وتعلمنا في باب الكفاءة في النكاح وهذا مهم. We have also discussed previously the chapter of equality or compatibility with regards to the marriage. وهذا مهم. كم من الرجال أهم شيء لهن أو أهم شيء لهم جمال النساء. وهذا خطأ. How many of the men, the most important thing to them is how beautiful is the young lady? Is she a J-Lo? Is she a كذا وكذا? كم طول شعرها? How long is her hair? كم مقاس كذا وكذا? How big is this? How thick is that? How tall is this? How short is this? How brown is she? How light skin is she? How dark is she? وهذا خطأ. And this is a grave error. والذي يدل على ذلك نتائج نكاحنا. And that which points to this is the result of our marriages. إخوان. فلذلك فتحنا درسا في هذا الباب. So for this, by the permission of Allah, we were able to open up a lesson in this chapter of marriage. ونسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن ينفعنا جميعا وأن يعلمنا بماذا ينفعنا وينفعنا بماذا يعلمنا. And we ask Allah that He teaches us that which will cause us benefit and that He benefits us from that which He has taught us. فَآخُرُ بَابٍ تَعَلَّمْنَاهُ أَوْ كُنَّا فِيهِ بَابٌ فِي الْعُيُوبِ فِي النِّكَاحِ. The last chapter we were reading from was the chapter with regards to the defects or the blemishes or illnesses that a person finds out after the marriage. That a person finds out after the marriage. كملنا هذا الباب يا اخوان. I think we completed this chapter. I think that was the last chapter we're on. I don't know if we completed it or not. The chapter of the defects.
Yeah, the last chapter we were on was on conditions made before marriage.
We completed that one. And we started the defects.
Oh, matter of fact, yeah, we did the first part. We didn't go into the second part.
طيب. قال الشيخ فوزان حفظه الله تعالى مراجعة. As a small review before we begin, قال هناك عيوب تثبت الخيار في النكاح منها. Sheikh Fawzan, he says, with regards to the marriage, there are certain defects that if they are there, or illnesses or blemishes that are there, if they weren't there before the marriage, the person who finds out, the young lady or the brother, has the right to nullify the marriage. Has the right to nullify the marriage. قال الشيخ فوزان أن من وجدت زوجها لا يقدر على الوطئ لكونه عنيا أو مقطوع الذكر فلها الفسخ. فلها الفسخ. He says, for instance, a woman, she finds out, or she finds that her husband, وهذا يحصل, and this happens, إخوان. This happens. How many questions the sisters write? Brother, such and such and such and such. Ask them a sheikh, such and such and such and such. The sheikh, he says, a woman, she finds out, or she finds that her husband doesn't have the ability to have relations with her. He doesn't have the ability to have relations with her. For instance, maybe he is aniyan. He is, for you children, cover your ears here. He is impotent. أو مقطوع الذكر, keep your ears covered. Or his private part is cut off, is amputated from the private part. فلها الفسخ. This young lady here, she has the right to nullify the marriage. She has the right to nullify the marriage. So إلنا قبل, we were asked previously, إذا المرأة تعرف هذا قبل العقد فهل لها الفسخ؟ فهل لها الفسخ؟ الجواب لا. الجواب لا. A question came, I believe in the last lesson, a sister asked, if a young lady is aware of this before the marriage, but she accepts it, can she come back after the marriage and invalidate the marriage? The answer is no. The answer is no. Why? لأنها رضيت به قبله. Because she accepted it before the marriage. So she can't say that this is a defect here. Because she had knowledge of it. She had to sit down with Brother Fulan. And he explained to her, sister, I'm a little weak in this regard. I don't have the quwwah of al-rijal. I don't have the strength of the men. بعد العشاء, after Isha time. He explains to her, in this regard, I'm not as strong. He makes it clear to her. She رضيت به. She accepts it. تعرفه. She has knowledge of it. ورضيت به. And she affirmed it. She is pleased with it. She accepts it. Now, she can't come after the marriage and say al-fasakh. And say al-fasakh. And try to invalidate the marriage. قال تفضل يا أحمد.
Hey, Naeem, I asked a question. I wanted to ask this last week, but it slipped my mind. On the same topic, dealing with the marriage, say for a man is incarcerated.
And
he wants to marry his sister, and he informs her of the time that he has, and she accepts it. She knows that the man says, girl, I have 25 years, and she accepts it, right? But then later on it starts to become
difficult upon her.
Can she rescind out of the marriage after?
I'm here. That's a good question, Ya Ahmed. The brother's asking about if a sister is married to a brother incarcerated. And this happens. And a benefit, it's many of the ulama, they criticize a marriage to someone in jail. They say, what type of marriage would that be? How can the man give you your four rights while he's locked down? How can he protect you? How can he spend on you? How can he upbraid, give you the tarbiyah, upraise you? At any rate, there are some scholars also who say that this is allowed, that this is allowed. And the fact that he's locked up doesn't prohibit you from getting married. Ahmed is asking about a young lady who asks, or she's married to her brother that's locked down, and he has a nice amount of time. She agreed to it at first. They get married, but now it becomes difficult upon her. Can this one invalidate the marriage? Here, she can't invalidate it. Same principle, because she had knowledge of it previously. So she can't come back and say, uyuban, uyuban, a defect, a defect. She can't say that. However, she can ask for khulu'. She can ask for khulu'. It's allowed for her if she feels that she has an Islamic reason. Many of our nisa, ya ikhwan, ala al-asaf, ماذا يسألنا رجالهن خلعاً بدون عذر شرعي وهذا خطأ وهذا خطأ. Many of our women, unfortunately, they ask the men for khul' without an Islamic reason, and this is an error. And this is an error for such a young lady. The Messenger of Allah mentioned she will not smell the fragrance of the Jannah. She will not smell the fragrance of the Jannah, even if the brother adhina bihi, even if he says yes. For example, the man takes on a third wife, fourth wife, second wife especially. Most of the African-American women, oh, إذا أنت تريد أن تعرف هل زوجتك تحبك لله أم لا, اتخذ بثانية. اتخذ بثانية. If you want to know if your wife really loves you for Allah, you're going to see when you take on a second family, or a third family, or a fourth family. Usually, and we're not trying to criticize African-American women, usually the women are women. The first thing she's going to say is, ah, khulu', khulu', khulu'. One Arabic word our women have down, khulu', khulu'. She's going to say it perfect, alhamdulillah. Every letter she's going to say it accurately. MashaAllah, like tajweed, like she's reciting Quran. At any rate, every young lady has this word down, khulu'. Last night, you were like a shams. You were like the sun in the sky. Or al qamar fil layl, or the moon in the night time. Now, second, third, or fourth, khulu', khulu', khulu'. Let me go, let me go, let me go. So now, even if the man says yes, and she doesn't have an Islamic reason, she doesn't smell the fragrance of the Jannah. So this young lady, her husband is in the prison, although she allowed or she accepted it at first, she can't come back and say, a defect, a defect. I have to nullify the marriage. She can't do that because she had knowledge of it previously. But she can ask for khulu'. And if the brother gives her the khulu', she takes her iddah. She takes her iddah, one iddah. And then after that, if she's not pregnant therein, she can continue to sit down if she wishes after that. Tafadhal
ya akhi. Yeah, just one more thing. It's still basic on that. We keep saying about the defect, and, you know, something that wasn't made clear in the beginning of the marriage. So now the opposite to that would be that if he wasn't truthful of the time that he had, or he misled her to think that he only had,
that'd be a good question. If
that he had a certain amount of time, but really had more time than,
that'd be a good question. Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentions, rahimahullah ta'ala, a tremendous statement that Sheikh Fawzan mentioned similarly. He says, this is slightly talking about that. At any rate, something like that, I don't know if you can call that a defect. You can call that khiyana, maybe the person not being honest, being deceitful. At any rate, some may argue if it's something that the young lady had knowledge of previously and she would have said no. For example, a man has two wives and he marries Sister Fulana, and she didn't know that he was married. Or the man has one wife rather, and she didn't know. They had to sit down, three or four. So they go ahead and make arrangements to get married. After that, he tells her, I have another wife. A person can say this is deceit. At any rate, deceit would be if he was asked about it or was mentioned and he failed to tell the truth. But here, you can't call that deceit because it wasn't mentioned. That's something else. How many things are not going to be mentioned in the sit down? The way we have sit-downs nowadays, Ikhwan, is different than the way the Salaf used to have sit-downs. In reality, some people may not even call what they used to have a sit-down. Reality. Some of them would ask questions family to family, friend to friend, and then they would get the look. The man would look at the woman. The woman would look at the man. If they رضي بهما الآخر, if they were pleased with one another, they were going to get married. How we sit down nowadays, it resembles dating. Most of us, how we sit down, it resembles dating. Doesn't mean that you can't be intended for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 6 months, 3 weeks, a month, a week. Not saying that. But the way most of our sit downs are, we sit down, for example, as if we're dating. We go out to the movie, maybe not the movies. We go out to we go out to Mada al-Hadaiq, to the park, to the beach. Down in Atlantic City, you have nice parks, alhamdulillah. You have the boardwalk with a third party, the husband, the father, grandfather, brother, son or daughter. At any rate, we do this for a year. Is that a sit-down? The answer would be no. That resembles, that's why I say resembles. That resembles dating. Is it allowed? Yes. I'm not saying it's not allowed, Ya Khwan. The sister you're sitting down with, you and her father and her, go to the park. That's allowed. But once the things are there, all the questions have been answered, all the things have been placed in order, you had your look, she had her look. This is why the Messenger of Allah said, from the things we don't delay is marriage. Everything is in place. So why are we waiting? And usually when we do this, usually you fall into looks that we shouldn't look at. You fall into actions that we shouldn't fall into. Speech or talk that we shouldn't have with one another. At any rate. And then mostly we don't get married afterwards. We sat for 2 years. And now, oh, she's a liar. You was almost sitting fake sit down, if I can say that. Resemblance of dating for a whole year. And now all of a sudden, she's a liar. To the Salaf, usually when they marry, and I'm not recommending this, I'm just saying this, how they used to marry. They used to marry without really knowing one another. I'm not saying that to do that. Yes, the time was different. Yes, the people were different. The level of Iman, Aqwa, no one's going to argue. Their level of Iman was at a higher daraja, a higher level than our level of Iman. A shaitan used to see Umar, وَيُخَالِفُ طَرِيقًا, and he would go the other way. A shaitan, authentic hadith, a shaitan would see Umar walking down the street, and a shaitan would go the other way. La ilaha illallah, ya ikhwan, a shaitan. Now our time, now you see someone righteous, and we go the other way. You see someone you deem, an imam, a sheikh, someone of some knowledge, some good character, a sister who's not covering. She's going to say, oh, there's Sister Waliyah. There she is. Bismillah. No, make a left. Make a left. At any rate, we flee from good things. The one who is righteous is going to give you a reminder. When the man is about to smoke and he sees Shaykh Khalid, he says, make a left. Make a left. Bismillah. Make a left. So he can keep on smoking. So he don't get the reminder. The one who deems someone to be righteous, he should want to encounter the righteous man. لِمَاذَا لِاسْتِفَادَةِ مِنْهُ, to benefit from him. The one who's righteous is going to say, hey, أخي, اتَّقِ اللَّهِ, Allah Ta'ala يَنْظُرُ إِلَيْكَ, Allah يَنْظُرُ إِلَيْكَ. He's going to say, Allah Ta'ala is observing you. Allah Ta'ala is mindful of what you do. Allah Ta'ala is looking at you. The one who lies and he runs into someone righteous, he's going to say, Allah Ta'ala يَسْمَعُ إِلَيْكَ, Allah listens to you. Allah hears you. What earth can you go to? What sky is going to protect you? What earth is going to shield you from the punishment of Allah Ta'ala? So we shouldn't run from the righteous, but rather we should be in contact with the righteous. Our friends should be righteous. That's why we have to get our wives off Facebook and off Instagram and off her gram and his gram and Hotmail and Yatmail. Wallahi, Ikhwan, most of our wives are not married to us. Sadly to say. Most of our wives are not married to us. But some of our wives are not married to us. They're married to Hotmail. When she wakes up, the first thing she does, she's on the Hotmail. She's on Twitter. Oh, Twitter, la ilaha illallah, Twitter, wallahi, Ikhwan. Twitter has fit, if I can say, فتنت كثيرا من أمهات من أمهاتنا has fitnatized my own English Arabic word has fitnatized has distracted many of our women.
I'm going to jail.
From the time she wakes up, Twitter. From the time she prays after Salaamu Alaikum wa Alaikum Salaam, Twitter. After the wudu, Twitter. After the Jumu'ah, Twitter. In Jumu'ah, Twitter. Going to Jumu'ah, Twitter. Dressing the kids, Twitter. She's dressing herself, Twitter. Listening to the Jumu'ah, she's on Twitter. She's on Instagram. She's on Hotmail. She has no Salah, no Jumu'ah. How many questions the sisters write? Can you please remind us as the women not to text throughout the Jumu'ah, not to check our email throughout the Jumu'ah, not to check our Facebook throughout the Jumu'ah? The one who is in the back in our masjid here, opening up her Facebook, her Twitter, and pictures come up. All the angels in the Musalla leave because she opened up her Twitter. So now, if she's having a conversation with someone, she has no Salah, number one. Everyone else in that Musalla, that same Musalla, are praying, making dua, but the angels are not there. Likewise in our homes. Well, like pictures, ya ikhwan. May Allah Ta'ala protect us and forgive us and have mercy upon us and our future with regards to picture taken. Picture taken is a fitna, especially on the women, the African American women. And not only the women, on many of us. One Jumu'ah, last Jumu'ah, where I pray, ikhwan. Tell you, Al-Jumu'ah to Qabla التي فاتت, the Jumu'ah before last week. كنا في Pleasantville. We were in Pleasantville. ومباشرة بعد الصلاة خرجنا ونظرنا إلى رجلين أو ثلاثة رجال يأخذون صورة قائمين أمام باب المسجد. أمام المسجد. Right after the Salah, we came out, maybe two or three brothers, right after the Jumu'ah, right in front of the masjid, posing, on the side of the masjid, posing, taking pictures. Posing. Hook me up. Let me get my right side. Alhamdulillah. Ibrahim, get me on the left. Get me on the right. One more. I got to put this on my Facebook. It ain't no more than women. Now it's the brothers also. In front of the masjid. If we're not going to have no shyness at the masjid, where are we going to have shyness at? Most of us are Muslims in the masjid. Alhamdulillah. Nobody's going to beat his wife in the masjid. No wife. Now it's flipped around also. We don't only beat the wives. Now they beat us also. No wife is going to beat the husband in the masjid. For example, the one who beats his child in the masjid is going to have some shyness. He's going to say, Ya Abdullah, عندما نأخذ إلى البيت. He's going to say, when we get to the house, he's going to have shyness. He's not going to beat his son in front of everyone on the musalla floor. If we don't have shyness in the masjid, Ya Akhwan, as-su'al, the question is, متى نستحي لله? When are we going to be shy in front of Allah Ta'ala? If it's not the masjid, many of our brothers, and this is not a criticism to the brothers, but I'm talking about the brothers in this masjid here. And it's not a criticism to the women, but I'm talking about the women in this masjid here. أكثر من الرجال المتزوجين لا يحضرون الدروس ولا الصلوات بعائلتهم. وهذا على الأسف. Most of the men in this city here, Atlantic City, who are married, not the single man, they're married brothers. And I'm not talking about no one. Before anyone gets offended, I'm talking about an action. I'm not talking about no one per se, but that. I'm talking about an action. فِعْلًا مِنَ الْأَفْعَالِ An action from the actions. Most of our beloved married brothers don't come with their families to the salah nor to the lessons. So if we don't study with our wives and we don't pray with our wives, what else are we not doing? That's the asl, the origin. الْإِيمَانِ لا يأتي إلا بعد الإم بعد العلم. Knowledge or belief is not going to be acquired except after knowledge. That's why Sheikh As-Sa'di, he says, every time the person ماذا يحصل على العلم يزيد بالإيمان. كما قال رحمه الله. Every time the person increases himself, herself in knowledge, his iman should increase. Usually, or as the imam he said رحمه الله. Likewise, the opposite. Most of our married women in the back, not the single woman, the married sister. Most of our married sisters, talking about us, we can always talk about Ahlul Bid'ah, and we can point the finger at this one and this one. Let's look at ourselves, Ya Ikhwan. Ila anfusina. Let's look at us. Let's talk about me. And let's talk about my family. And let's talk about my brothers. And let's talk about my sisters. And let's talk about my wife. And let's talk about my kids. Let's talk about us, Ya Ibadallah. Before we point the finger, Let's yamiluhu, or namiluhu, let's point it to ourselves. Most of our wives, most of our mothers, most of our daughters who are married, they don't come to the lessons with their family. Usually it's a brother, his wife is home. Or it's a sister, the husband is home or working. And the ones who are working, they have an excuse. We're not talking about them, ikhwan. We're talking about the ones who have no excuse. The ones who have excuse, they know who they are. We're not talking about that individual. We're talking about the one, adamu al-udhur, the one who has no excuse. The question is, if we're not praying together, and we're not having a class with our wives and our daughters, then what else are we not doing? Because the same young lady, I guarantee, she's going to put double the time on Twitter. I guarantee she's going to put a third of the time on Facebook. I remember telling my own family. I use myself as an example. I remember telling my own family, Abu Abdullah, my own family. If you can give, I'm not even asking half and half. Give Twitter half and give your Quran half. La la la. هذا صعب. وأنا أعرف ذلك. I know that's difficult. I'm not even going to ask that. Give Twitter 3 hours and give Quran 3 hours. That's too difficult. I know that's hard. I'm not even going to ask that. Give half. I'm not going to ask that either. That's also hard. You give Twitter 3 hours, give an hour and a half to your Quranic studies, your Islamic studies. That's still difficult. Depending on how long you're on Twitter, some of the women, 2, 3, 4, 5, since the man went to work and he came home, some brothers work 8 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours. You're still in the same spot with the same curlers in your hair, with the same pajamas, the little kids still running around, and you're still on Twitter? Downloading pictures, taking pictures, downloading this, screenshotting this, backbiting this, telcaring that, slandering this one. Wallah. How many hours? Give half of that to your Quranic studies. That's too difficult. I wasn't even asking for that. I said, give a quarter. Add up the time that you're usually on the internet. Wasting your time. Add it up. Now, divide it. A third. Give that to your Islamic studies. Many of us can't do that. So the question is, what about the children? I hear the brothers talking about a new building. I say, we're not ready for that type of speech yet. What's my proof? Nahnu, we are our own proofs. Many of the brothers, hey, we need a building. Even the sisters, mashallah. Ya ikhwan, we need a building. I say to the people of knowledge, we don't need a building yet. Not Abu Abdullah, the people of knowledge, we don't need a building. What's my proof? I remember I mentioned a narration to you. سألنا شيخنا نفس السؤال متى يعرف شخص بأنه يحتاج إلى بناء جديد. I remember a question we posed to our own Sheikh. Sheikh, in our communities back home, how do we know when we need a new masjid, a new building? He says, كم يصلي معكم في الفجر. He says, how many of the brothers pray with you, brothers, in the Fajr? We said at this time, خمسة. Sittatul Rijal, Saba'a, Arba'a, we said 5, 6, 7, usually 4. Qala wa kam yusalli ma'akum al-jum'a. He said, how many pray with you on the Jumu'a? We said, 150, 170, 200. We said, 150, 170, or the likes, 200, 5 in Fajr, 150. 100 in Jumu'ah. He says, أنتم لا تحتاجون إلى البناء جديد. He says, wallahi, you brothers are not in need of a new building. On Jumu'ah, we're busting out the door. The Shaykh says, لا. عندما يقا أو يشبه عددكم للفجر بعدد الجمعه فأنتم حينئذ محتاجون إلى بناء جديد. And he says something similar to, when your numbers of the Fajr resemble or equal your numbers of the Jumu'ah, now you're in need of a new building. What's the benefit of us talking about a new building if we have this small building? In every Salah, Fajr, 2 brothers. Fajr, 3 brothers. Fajr, 1 brother sometimes. Usually, no more than 4 brothers, usually, the norm. Dhuhr, maybe 6, 7. Asr, a little more. Alhamdulillah, Maghrib, 7. Isha, the likes. Jumu'ah, this whole musalla is jam-packed. The next Jumu'ah, when you come in, look around, ya ikhwan. When we say look around, that's to look around. Look at ourselves. Look around. Three rooms are filled up. Jumu'ah. Outside of Jumu'ah, not even 75%. Not even 20%. Not even 10% outside of Jumu'ah. So why the talk of a new building? Let's talk about how to fill this small building. Let's talk about how to raise some money. We can't even put down sadaqah, for example. When was the last time we brought some new books for the masjid? At any rate, that was that type of speech there, it appears that we're not ready for it. So now the young lady comes, back to Ahmed's question, and the man lied about the time that he had, or she wasn't aware of it. Could this be a defect? Allah knows best. We have to ask the people of knowledge here. Could she have the right to get a khulu', or can she have the right to ask for khulu'? The answer is yes. But will we call this a aib? Allahu a'lam. I don't have no knowledge to say this would be a defect. However, her not having knowledge of something is not a defect all the time. It depends on what it is. However, we have to pose this to the people of knowledge. As Allah Ta'ala says, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ ذِكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَتَعْلَمُونَ. As He says, ask the, in Surah An-Nahl, in Surah An-Biya, ask the people of knowledge when you do not know. قال الشيخ فوزان وإن دعت أنه عني فأقر بذلك أجل سنة فإن وطئ فيها وإلا فلها الفسخ. He says, so if the young lady, she claims that the man is impotent, he can't have relations with her. If the man agrees to this, he doesn't argue it. He says, yes, it's, I don't have that strength, ya ikhwan. This man here, he's to be given a year. He's to be given a year. If he has relations with her in this year, then he remain. Because her issue was, he doesn't have relations with me. He's given a year. If he can have relations in this year, alhamdulillah. If not, yes, she has the right to nullify the marriage. She has the right to nullify the marriage. قال وإن وجد الرجل في زوجته عيبا يمنع الوطأ كالرتق ولا يمكن زواله فله الفسخ. Likewise, if the man, and this happens, if the man, he finds in his wife a defect, and this defect prohibits them from having relations. It could be a sickness, an illness, a disease, or the likes. Something that doesn't allow them to have relations. It stops her from being intimate with the man. This man here, and such a sickness, it can't be removed. Or there's no cure, or there's no way to get rid of it, or the likes. So it stops them from having relations. This man, yes, can nullify the marriage. This man can nullify the marriage. قال الشيخ فوزان وكذا من وجد منهما في الآخر عيبا مشتركا كالباصور والجنون والبرص والجذام وقرع الرأس وبخر الفم فله الخيار لما في ذلك من النفرة. لما في ذلك من النفرة. He says, likewise, if one of the parties finds a defect in the other party, like hemorrhoids, like senility, not senility, craziness. Some of us, when we marry, how many of us, you have to sit down, you're like, oh, mashallah, a little J, alhamdulillah, Sheikh Khalid, oh, I got to get you a gift for this one, akh. And then you get home. Yes, salam. Yes, salam. The real sister comes out. Most of our women, they have bipolar. Most of our women here, ikhwan. How many times in the sit down? Oh, her hair is mashallah. Look how long her hair is. Oh, look how tall she is. Look how short. Look how light. Look, whatever the person likes. Look how dark. Look how brown. Some of the brothers, alhamdulillah, one of the brothers asked me this week, he's interested in someone. He said, I like the tall sisters, ya akhi. He has that right. My only thing is, he's a short brother. But he likes the tall, you can like what, it just ain't going to look too right. She's up here and he's down here. At any rate, he likes the tall sisters. You have a preference. Some of the women, mashallah, they like the brothers who are athletic, not the brothers who are a little chubby or the likes. They have that right. The only thing is that most of them are not athletic. We don't really match. The man who is, his bar is really high, he doesn't fit his own bar. Yeah, I want a sister, alhamdulillah, she memorized, at least, either she got to memorize the whole Quran or half of the Quran.
If she don't got down Bukhari, she at least got to have half a Bukhari. She got to be speaking Arabic. She got to cover her face, alhamdulillah. And he's sitting there in front of you with a Sean John sweatsuit on. Doesn't come to none of the lessons. The last time he came to the masjid was last Eid, for instance. And his bar is so high, he doesn't fit his own bar. He wants a sheikha, but he's nowhere near a sheikh. He's nowhere near a student. Likewise, the women. Wallah, listen to some of the women, ikhwan. Oh, brother, I want a student of knowledge. MashaAllah, an imam of a masjid, someone on a microphone. And that's a fitna. Many of our women, wallah, ikhwan. The same way many of the men are tested with the microphone. I want to be the one teaching. A lot of brothers can't ask me questions. He never called me a sheikh. I was never asked to do Jumu'ah. I never led the salah. I'm not selected to do a lesson. The women are tested with the microphone also. Oh, I want the microphone, brother. Why? Because he's on the microphone. No, that's not going to benefit you. Yom Qiyamah.
Sheikh, there was a sister that, when Amin was the imam here, his sister said, I don't want no one except a student of knowledge.
Well, same thing in Philly. Same thing in Philly. Some of the sisters, well, they tell you straight up. Sometimes you have a sit down, the sister say to you, excuse me, brother, you imam? That's her first question. You an imam somewhere? Hey, what does that have to do with my Islam? Hey, what, you got CDs out? One sister in Philly, you won't mention no names. That's this the brother who brung it to me one time. I won't mention his name. At any rate, the brother said, there's a young lady, she wants to know, alhamdulillah, if you'll be interested. Her first question is, how many CDs you got out?
SubhanAllah.
I'm thinking it's a game. It's like the rap game. For example, how many underground tapes you done made, you produced? But like, it's, wallah, it's, but most of our, some of our women are also tested with the microphone. I want someone on a mic. I want someone who's teaching. I want an imam, not to benefit from him. That's honorable. I want someone that can teach me my religion. That's praiseworthy. I want someone, I'm not going to learn with him. I'm not going to sit. I just like, you know how back in the day, before Islam, the brothers used to sell drugs. And the young lady wanted to be with him for like the ash'an. Like the fame, the reputation. Oh, I'm Little Mike's girl. I'm Little Mike's baby mom, for example. And Little Mike could care less. At any rate, same thing in Islam now. I want a student. I want someone in Medina. Someone who went to Yemen. Someone who was in Egypt. Not to benefit from him. To benefit from him is honorable. But most of our women are not going to learn. Or don't have the desire to learn. It's just the sit down fake out. And the sit down, everyone is, oh, they have the soft voice. MashaAllah, brother. Everything is mashallah. Whatever you ask is mashallah. Whatever you ask. Can you cook? Alhamdulillah. I do cooking classes for the sisters of the whole masjid. Alhamdulillah. How was your house? Oh, my house is the cleanest. I was raised with my grandmother. Alhamdulillah. Everything is alhamdulillah bil alameen. Do you come to the lessons? Oh, I go to all the lessons, mashallah. Sister Wali, I'm her top student. Alhamdulillah, ask her about me. I answer all the questions. How do you feel about polygamy? Oh, I'm Salafi, alhamdulillah. This from my minhaj. The messenger, then she recites some hadith. The messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You be like, okay, alhamdulillah. And as soon as you get home, you call in the masjid the first night. Yes, Salam Ibrahim. Listen, where's the brother that married me off? Before the brothers leave, somebody got to get me out of this marriage. I don't know who you married me to. I thought I was marrying a sheikha. Sheikha? She can't even spell sheikha. You rushing to get her back home, to get her back from the house. Says, you got to get out of this house. You got, Sheikh Khaled, come get this sister. You just leave your own. You know it's bad when you leave your own house. You can have it. At any rate, we have to stop looking at the beauty. Like that. That's every community. May Allah help us, ikhwan. May Allah help us.
Right? Your brother got married to the sister.
Soon they got home.
The next day, their brother, look, come get him. It's done over with. Come to find.